Supriya, let us know, where are you from and what has been your journey like? What is your niche and what did the hackathon do to you as a person? Let us know. Yes, Supriya, we can see you, we can hear you. Congratulations once again.
Thank you so much. Oh, I'm so nervous. Okay, I prepared. I also forgot everything.
Yes, okay. Go with the flow. Let us know what was the journey like.
Okay, I bought your course way back in 2019, impulsively. But I just completely forgot about it. It was lying in my inbox for quite some time. It was only in 2020 September when the organization I was working closed due to COVID and I was jobless. Although I continued freelancing, but I was like in this space of like, what next? What else can I do? I do not know how much further I can do in this freelancing, how long will that journey be? I was in that the space of uncertainty. And then I suddenly remember that, there is this course of Siddharth, because I used to, obviously, I used to see you constantly on Facebook, your YouTube videos and all that. So I was like, okay, I have bought his course and it's somewhere lying in my inbox. So I just retrieved it in probably like December 2020. And then I realized that the hackathon was already going on and like towards the fag end of that particular hackathon. So I thought, okay, I'll join from Jan 2021. And two hackathons went by and I was not yet a freedom finisher. It was the third hackathon when I became a freedom finisher. And the first thing was definitely, yes, the mission, because that was very clear. Because yes, I've been working as a special education teacher for quite some time and I have been hearing the pain points of parents about how they are finding it very difficult to get their children to read and all that. So that, those things used to come in my mind. And all those advices I used to give them, they were finding it difficult to implement it. They were saying, yes, but they're finding it very difficult to get them motivated, to make them sit. We don't have time, a lot of things. So that was another thing that kept running in my mind, that I must do something to help them. That was always there. So the niche was not a problem. The final niche, the micro niche was not a problem. The problem for me was consistency and that confidence and the hand-holding that I required. That's where hackathon helped me, the hand-holding, because everything, mind you, you are like, we are like kindergarten children, you're hand-holding us in every step. That definitely helped me. Hackathon was, very helpful for me in regaining my confidence and going through every step, because there are so many elements in hackathon, the technical part, the video recording, so many things are there. Yes, the other thing was, the other reason why I succeeded in the third hackathon was I enrolled in the Diamond membership. That was a game changer for me. Because yes, it might look like I'm promoting Diamond membership, but yes, I am promoting Diamond membership. It was totally very helpful. I'm part of Avengers and all the members, Neena Ji, Amar Pratap, Noble, Prakhar Kulshreshta, Renjini, they've been amazing, a lot of ideas, a lot of support, a lot of encouragement there. And also, yes, Hemant, though he's not part of Images, even he has been very good motivator, encouraged, a lot of encouragement from his side. So yes, the tribe, the hive and the hive meetups, all those things are very motivating and gives you a lot of ideas. So yes, the Diamond membership, the hackathon, hand-holding, all those helped me. And I've just started recording the L2 because I thought, yes, okay, this L1 is good. It's just like a warming up kind of a thing, but this is not enough. I have to do the more detailed, there's so much more I want to give and there is so much more now running in my mind. And I just started L2 recording videos, though I haven't really made so much in terms of the revenue. I just got 3 enrollments, but that's okay.
Great. I mean, you got to celebrate that you've just launched. And that's great.
Yeah.
That first sale is always magical. Like, do you remember the first sale? What did you feel like?
The first sale, actually the first sale was one of my tribe member only. When I told her I'm giving you free of cost. She said, okay. Why are you giving free of cost? I'll pay for it.
Nice.
And she paid for it, and I was like, and I was kind of scared because all this integration was kind of the technical thing was really scary for me. Have I integrated correctly? The payment gateway, have I done it correctly? All that fear was there. And when the payment went through, and I got that from
Razorpay, notification,
the notification from Razorpay that she has enrolled, and all, I was like, okay, good. Which this is also you know, a confirmation it's working, and I've done it all right.
Amazing. So now on technology, are you hands-on? You're able to manage all the systems,
yes,
all the basic systems?
Yes. Yeah.
Amazing.
That's the reason, the website thing, initially I did by myself because I thought, let me try it out. It was when I got really stuck, then I approached the digital
market.
Yeah.
Amazing. Great, Supriya. Thank you so much for sharing your journey and even the work that you're doing, working with parents, now helping children. So what is your topic? You work with parents to help them with special needs children. Is that what you mentioned?
This particular course of parents is not specifically for special needs, but for parents.
All children.
Yes. Age group 3 to 7 years. I'm targeting 3 to 7 years because the foundation. That is where the initial grooming, where you can get the child interested in reading on the tech list. Because I noticed, because as a special education teacher, that children who are not exposed to reading at young age, they have very tough time in school. School years gets even more difficult. But when they're exposed to print, they have getting into that habit of reading and building inquiry and curiosity. Their journey is much more smoother. So I wanted that, to help parents in that. Because I've seen parents run pillar to post. It is very sad, and that was like, I need to do something, for them. I need to empower them. That's why I called my course, the L1 Tripwire, as Empowered Teaching Blueprint.
Empower the parents. Nice.
Yeah.
Fantastic, Supriya. Thank you for what you do. It may seem only 3 sales right now, but I think one year down the line, 2 years down the line, when you have thousands of people in your community, you're going to look back and think about this moment and say, I'm so glad I did this, because this activity of yours, it's not going to have an impact just on, that parent or child. It's probably an entire, the lifestyle of what's going to happen afterwards. So thank you so much for what you do. More power to you.
Thank you.
Yes. All of you just type PTY in the comment box. More power to Supriya and for the great work that she's doing.